Introduction. At times like these, when a global pandemic is threatening lives across all nations, soccer falls into perspective. Actually, we've discovered it isn't more important than life or death, despite the oft-made claims to the contrary. But the plague will pass and life will return to a normality of sorts soon enough. While we wait anxiously for that moment, it's important to stay fit. As good a way as any is to use our individual fitness regimes to help improve our soccer skills at the same time. So many coaching books require complex equipment, copious resources, and fantastic facilities. In producing Practice Soccer at Home, we're seeking to offer a guide for those times when we train alone, in our backyard, with little more than a ball and our immediate environment. Undertaking this additional work is important whether we are professionals seeking to perfect our technique at the highest level, why else would top professionals build home gyms into their luxurious houses, or more relevantly for this book, keen amateurs or youth players looking to develop our own game. With jobs to hold down, school to attend and such like, it's unlikely that in the best of times we'll get more than two formal training sessions per week, plus a match at the weekend. Realistically, it's likely to be just one session. So in order to maximise our potential, we must do some work on our skills and endurance alone. The most practical place for many of us is to undertake the training at home. Why get in the car to drive to the gym or park if we have a backyard we could use instead? The answer is, of course, what to do in the backyard and what to do it with. This book provides some answers to those questions. Seeking a small silver lining to even the darkest of clouds, such as the one circulating the world at the time of reading, we can see that for those of us consigned to home, self-isolating or acting on the instructions of our governments, we do at least have the time to get outside with a ball and hone those skills which have thus far eluded us. For the tips and drills that follow, we have assumed a backyard of 30 metres by 30 metres. We've assumed access to a wall or some other form of rebound. We'll highlight some useful commercial products which can make our practice easier. Nothing too expensive, though. Beyond that, we'll make suggestions of everyday items we can use to help set up the drills and practices. Where a drill can be made easier to follow with the use of an illustration, we've added a diagram. If you download the PDF that came with this audiobook, you'll find the key to that. In total, this book contains drills for individuals, pairs and small groups to try in their backyard. Numerous tips to get the most from a session. Some solo, paired and small group games to make training fun. Exercises that can be undertaken at home and in the backyard to improve fitness and flexibility. Some mental health guidance. Outlines of key techniques for reference. Key skills on which the drills work. More than 30 diagrams to help with understanding the more complex drills. And as I said before, the key for the diagrams illustrating some of the drills can be found in the PDF file that you should download with this audiobook. You'll find the key in diagram 1.